You can become a partner in hope. And Riley Green is here right now. You volunteered this time to come up here. Hey, bud, how are you?
Good. How y'all doing?
Good. How big old boy are you?
I'm about 6'3 to 6'4, somewhere in there with boots and 200 pounds.
Okay, he also gives his height with shoes on.
Yeah.
That's what Bobby likes to
do. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, what's the point in giving it without shoes on?
Because it's how tall are you? And then, but I don't ever say how tall I am in heels.
Why are you so medical all of a sudden?
No, it's just, I thought you have a, when
you say something different with heels, you know?
Yeah, because like, that would be awesome. I would be like 5'7", 5'8".
Because I say I'm 6 foot, 6'1", in the right Jordans. And then they're all like, they didn't do that to you, though, because you're big. Yeah, big dude.
No, I actually did just call him out on it.
Yeah, but you didn't give him the sass like you do me. Okay. He thought it was cute when he did it. Yeah.
Sure.
Riley Green is here, St. Jude Radiothon. If you're listening now, what we'd love for you to do is become a partner in hope. Just $20 a month. Help the kids at St. Jude fight cancer. Text the word Bobby to 785-833. Click the link from St. Jude to donate. I know for you, Riley, that you've played a bunch of concerts to help raise money for St. Jude.
Yeah, it's, you know, it's. I always say it's pretty cool to be able to play guitar and sing songs for a living, but to be able to do it for something that's a good cause, you know, it makes it that much better, and it's always really cool because you see the support for something like that, you know.
Volunteering his time on the road and his time here, and we couldn't be more grateful. So while you're listening to Riley Green about to play a song here that I love, if you are moved and you have $20 a month that you can spare, we'd love for you to become a partner in hope. I'll say it one more time. Text the word Bobby to 785-833. And just know this, that you know, so many hospitals, when they create treatments, they keep them for themselves so they can make more money. At St. Jude, that's not what it's about. At St. Jude, they discover it, they share it freely. So every kid that is saved at St. Jude means that doctors and scientists can use that knowledge to save thousands of more kids around the world. So just know that it's not only about the kids being there, but it's about the treatment and the discoveries they make and just openly sharing it. And that's why Riley is here today. So Let's do a little bit of music. What are you going to play for us?
I'm going to play a cover I've been doing for about the last 10 years. It's, I'm a big Jamey Johnson fan growing up, In Color.
Okay, here we go.
I said, Grandpa, what's this picture here? It's all black and white. It ain't real clear, and is that you there? He said, yeah, I was 11. And times were tough back in 35. It's me and Uncle Joe just trying to survive a cotton farm and a Great Depression. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, should have seen it in color. This one here was taken overseas in the middle of hell. It's 1943 in the wintertime. You can almost see my breath. That was my tail gunner, old Johnny McGinn. He was a high school teacher from New Orleans, and he had my back through the day we left. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other, should have seen it in color. And a picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep cover. Should have seen it in color. This one is my favorite one. This is me and Grandma and that summer sun all dressed up. The day we said our vows. You can't tell it here. Hell, it was hot that June. That rose was red and her eyes are blue. And just look at that smile. I was so proud. And that's the story of my life. And it's right there in black and white. And if it looks like we were scared to death, like a couple of kids just trying to save each other. Should have seen it in color. And a picture's worth a thousand words, but you can't see what those shades of gray keep covered. Should have seen it in color.
That's Riley Green. That's awesome, man. Yeah. It's always tough to do a song that is really emotional and wonderful by the original artist. Man, you killed that one. That's great.
Thanks, man. Yeah. Appreciate it.
Riley Green's here. What we'd like for you to do if you're listening right now is to become a partner in Hope. For $20 a month, you can help the kids at St. Jude fight cancer. Again, I'll read you the text number. You can text the word Bobby to 785-833. Click the link from St. Jude and donate. And when you do, you'll receive the special edition Pimp and Joy shirt made just for today. So text Bobby to 785-833. And remember that families never receive a bill from St. Jude for treatment. You take your kids, you're there, travel, housing, food, treat, all of that's covered. Because their goal is to make sure that if you're a family and you're there, you're just worried about your kid. And that's why we're here today. That's why Riley's here today. That's why we're thankful that you're listening and becoming a partner in Hope. And if you can share and become a partner in Hope for $20 a month, we'd love for you to do it. Our Riley Green is here. By the way, you can follow him on Instagram, Riley Duckman. Riley Duckman. Riley, it looks like Riley Duckman. What is it? It's Riley Duckman, right?
I think it was Duckman, yeah.
Like the Duckman?
I mean, I was a big duck hunter when Instagram became a thing for me, but also maybe Riley Green was taken at the time. I don't really remember, but that's Duckman's what it is now.
You can't, like, get your own name, because I'll have, like, people go, like my TikTok name. Somebody had my name on TikTok, so we had to call and do the thing, but it's an important, because you have Riley Green Music on Twitter and Riley Duckman on Instagram.
Yeah, well, I mean, I have just as many people that think that's my last name.
Well, when I said Duckman, I was like, well, it's like super, like Spider-Man.
Yeah, I mean, I was nobody when I did Instagram, so now it's kind of like I'm already been Duckman for so long, I might as well just stay him.
You get you a duck endorsement, get you like a duck call.
Yeah, I got people send me duck calls and stuff all the time. There was people that come out of the bars and would recognize me from like a hunting show or something before they even knew I played music. So, you know, it's pretty neat how social media can let you hunt for free. That's always fun for me.
What kind of hunt show did you do?
It was just like some buddies of mine had cameras, and we went out, and I just goofed off and hunted a little bit, and they videoed it. I mean, it wasn't anything that I really put a lot of thought into, but it's called Halo Country, and it's a free app. It's on, I guess, phone, any kind of phone. You got a smartphone, you can download it and watch us goofing around and chasing animals in the woods.
And you play ball, huh?
I did. I played a little bit of football in college at Jacksonville State, and I was a lot more worried about chasing girls around and playing music in bars than going to class, so my career was pretty short, but I was really into sports growing up, yeah.
Were you the guy in school? What were you known for more, the music guy or the athlete guy?
Probably athlete guy, because I would never sing in front of anybody for a long time, and I was probably, you know, 19 or 20 before I ever started going out and playing anywhere in a restaurant or anything, so it was the music thing was just something I kind of did for fun, and the sports thing was something I was really passionate about at the time. So it kind of swapped around when I realized people enjoyed things that I made up.
What was that first place that you went out and publicly sang?
It was my great grandparents' house. We turned it into a music hall when I was a kid. Me and my granddaddy Buford did, and we called the Golden Saw Music Hall. Painted a big saw blade gold and put it on the wall, and a bunch of old people would go out there every week. And my granddaddy would be like, "Man, I'll give you $20 if you go sing Merle Haggard or something." And you know, I think I got a lot of false confidence from hanging out around all those old people, because they would cheer for me because I was the youngest person there. But
oh, I thought you were saying because they couldn't really hear.
Also fair.
He didn't think about that one until right now. I was like, yeah, oh yeah. Yeah,
I appreciate that.
But just so that you know, I mean, you actually can sing, so yeah. It's fine.
They're just smiling and nodding.
Yeah.
Riley Green's here, and he's here because today, as we continue our radiothon, we are asking that you become a partner in Hope for just $20 a month to help the kids at St. Jude fight cancer. Text Bobby to 785-833. They'll send you a link, click it, donate. You'll get the special edition Pimp and Joy shirt made just for today. And fitting that you bring up your grandfather, because your new song is called I Wish Grandpa's Never Died. And what I found interesting about this is, first of all, it's a great song, but when I'm a big who writes the song guy. Like, I'm a big songwriter guy. And when I looked and there were three writers on it, it's you and your two grandfathers.
That's right. Yeah. I wrote the song. Of course, my two granddaddies weren't living when I wrote the song. I wrote it about 2 months after my granddaddy Lennon passed away this February. And I always say my granddaddy Buford is probably the reason I got into music. He was such a big fan of country music and gave me my first guitar. And I just sort of wrote the song as a tribute to them. My album was done. You know, I just sort of wrote it just for myself and played it at a show. And you know how it is nowadays. Somebody videoed it and put it on YouTube and it got a million and something views. So I go to the label. I'm like, hey, you know, we might need to cut this. And I called my publishing company and said, is there any way I can put them on there as writers? You know, because my granddaddy was really witty. He was really good with words. And I think he would have been a good songwriter had that been something I was doing and when he was still alive. So I just thought, what cooler way than to have their name on something that's going to be around forever, especially a song called I Wish Grandpa's Never Died. So it was really special for me to be able to do that.
Here's Riley Green. He's going to play that for us right now.
Wish girls you love never gave back diamond rings. Wish every porch had a swing. Wish kids still learn to say sir and ma'am, how to shake a hand. Wish every state had a Birmingham. Wish everybody knew all the words to mama tried. And I wish Monday mornings felt just like Friday nights. And I wish even cars had truck beds. And every road was named Copperhead. And coolers never run out of cold Bud Light. And I wish high school home teams never lost. And back road drinking kids never got caught. And I wish the price of gas was low and cotton was high. And I wish honky tonks didn't have no closing time. And I wish grandpas never died. I wish Sundays on a creek bank would never end. Wish I could learn to drive again. Wish the first time 17 she was my everything. Kiss in a Chevrolet could happen every day. Wish everybody overseas was gonna make it home. And I wish country music still got played on country radio. And I wish even cars had truck beds. And every road was named Copperhead. And coolers never run out of cold Bud Light. And I wish high school home teams never lost. And back road drinking kids never got caught. And I wish the price of gas was low and cotton was high. And I wish honky-tonks didn't have no closing time. And I wish grandpas never died. And I wish grandpas never died. And I wish good dogs never got gray and old. I wish farms never got sold. And I wish even cars had truck beds. And every road was named Copperhead. And coolers never run out of cold Bud Light. And I wish high school home teams never lost. And back road drinking kids never got caught. And I wish the price of gas was low and cotton was high. And I wish honky-tonks didn't have no closing time. And I wish grandpas never died. I wish grandpas never died.
Riley Green, live in studio right now. That's great, man. Wow, look at that. Listen, you're probably hearing that song and maybe crying a little bit or reminiscing a bit about, well, anybody. The song can bring back a lot of memories. And you know, if you're in that real spirit of things and you also want to help out, I encourage you to become a partner in hope and text the word Bobby to 785-833. Click the link from St. Jude to donate. And remember that money they get, make sure the families never get a bill from St. Jude for treatment, travel, housing, food. Because again, the goal is that all the families should have to worry about is helping their kid. And imagine if you were in this situation, and God knows you don't want that to happen, but to a lot of people it does. And our goal here as a show and with you guys is to make sure the families can go in and St. Jude can continue its mission, finding cures and saving kids. So you can text the word Bobby to 785-833. I'm going to tell you, Riley, you're good, man. I don't know if anybody's ever told you that, but you're pretty good.
My mom tells me.
I'll be number two here. Riley's on his Get That Man a Beer tour. Still a few dates left this year. You can go to RileyGreenMusic.com. December 11th in New York. That one's sold out. Look at you. In the city. New York City. Sold out. The 12th in Philly. The 13th in Binghamton, New York. December 14th in Norfolk, Virginia. And you got an Atlanta show sold out. Look at you. You're killing it, man. What can you say? Who thought? You only been here like a year. Already playing these shows.
It's pretty crazy when you get your song on the radio, what can happen.
Got sold out right next to the shows. Look at you. Amy, anything you want to say to Riley?
Sorry about I made fun of your height. You're
6'3". You also said old people could stand to listen to me because they have the hearing aids turned down. So those two, we're two for two so far.
This is the first time we met, so I should probably, yes, I should say that you sound great and you're very tall.
Yeah, well, he said 6'3", but then 6'4" with his boots.
I'm trying to be honest. You know, like, I don't want to exaggerate.
Me. They asked me, I'm 6', 6'1" with the right Jordans.
There you go.
I'm with you. We're basically the same person, right? I don't know if you can tell, but we're a lot alike. People confuse us a lot.
Yeah. Like, I don't even know who's who right now.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's me, Bobby. We didn't switch seats.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right, Riley Green's here. Check him out, Riley Duckman on Instagram. It's like a superhero.
I kind of feel like one now.
Riley Duckman. Yeah, there he is. All right, Riley Green, everybody. Woo-hoo! Thank you very much. Good to
Thank
see you.
Thank you all. Appreciate it.